Hey guys, how's it going? Lady Survival here, and today I wanted to make a video talking about World of Warcraft Chronicle because these have been my favorite, most prized possessions. They're very heavy. I have all three of them here, and I wanted to show them to you so that you can be aware of their epicness. I freaking love them. I've had these for the last like year and a half, and I just started reading the first one, which I am almost done. I think I have about 20 pages left, and I have been obsessed, so I just kind of wanted to let you guys know. I know not all of my subscribers and followers play World of Warcraft or are interested in it, but for those that are, if you haven't read Chronicles, I just kind of wanted to let you know that they are totally worth getting because I can't put it down. Like sometimes Derek and I will be on WoW and I'll be like, hey, I think I'm gonna take a break and go read like a couple pages of Chronicle, and then it's like an hour later and I'm like, oops, I couldn't stop reading and I only meant to read just for like a little bit. I've also found myself staying up till like 3 in the morning, unable to put it down, and then I'm finally like, okay, I'm gonna stay up till sunrise if I don't stop. So I've just been obsessed, and I figured that if you're someone who likes WoW and you haven't checked it out, I would highly, highly recommend. I'm also pretty sure that the third book only goes up to, like, in a lore perspective, up to Cataclysm, which I feel like it's kind of crazy, like, how much WoW lore there is. Like, there's three whole books, and it only gets up to the point of Cataclysm. Like, they could basically release another three, and they'd probably barely get to the point of Shadowlands. But I'm just basically so excited to keep reading these. I've learned a lot from the first Chronicle so far, and I already know a lot about WoW lore because I have been a WoW lore junkie for the past, like, 4 years. I've been going really hard at it, but I've been obsessed with WoW lore for the past 10 years or so. But over the last 4 years, I've been spending a lot of time, like, really going hard, trying to learn every single thing about WoW lore. I spend an ungodly amount of time watching, like, Akalon and Pyromancer, Belluar, Taliesin. The list could go on, but those are definitely my favorites to watch. And I spend a lot of time on the WoW wiki and just looking up every lore character and making connections, and pretty much at all times, like, if I'm not directly busy voicing with Derek on Discord while I'm playing WoW, I'm listening to WoW lore stuff. While I'm getting ready, I'm listening to WoW lore stuff. I'm reading WoW lore. I'm just obsessed. So I wanted to share my love with you guys. Also, I really would have liked to read the Chronicles to you guys. That was an idea that I had. My kind of plan was, once I got back to Canada from visiting Derek in the States, I wanted to do kind of a video series of Lady Survival reading the Chronicle books, and I was going to do like a couple chapters per video or something like that, but I guess there's like copyright reasons why I cannot do that, so I don't think I'm going to bother taking the risk, although there are other YouTubers, like if you look up reading WoW Chronicles on YouTube, there are a few other YouTubers who have done it, so I mean, I might go for it and just hope that nothing comes of it, but like, God, that would really suck if I got sued. It's like, damn, I just love your books and WoW lore, like I just want to share it with people, but I guess it's complicated. It's probably better that I'm reading these for the first time on my own time, you know, so I can fully enjoy it and just kind of hang out laying down in my bed just reading it and not really feeling like kind of the pressure of like reading it for the first time when I haven't even enjoyed it for myself first. So I think I'm gonna finish reading them all myself regardless, and then maybe in the future I will do videos of me reading them and see if I can just not get in trouble for doing so. But I just thought that that would be really fun because basically my whole YouTube channel really is about World of Warcraft stuff. Like, that's why I started it. I know I do other stuff too, like just random vlogs, Killstar stuff, hair, makeup, like whatever, but really my channel is supposed to be about World of Warcraft stuff. That's why my name is Lady Survival, which is basically a spin on like Lady Sylvanas and the fact that I used to main a survival hunter, but now I don't play a survival hunter, but it was basically like Lady from Lady Sylvanas and then Survival from being a survival hunter. So my whole channel is supposed to be WoW themed, and I'd really like to kind of get back to that, but at the same time still entertain my other audience that enjoys just kind of my random vlogs and Killstar and all the other stuff that I do too. This is basically just kind of a nerdy video. I just wanted to talk about WoW books, basically. Not that exciting, but other than that, I wanted to give my friend on Instagram a shout out because she is amazing, and anytime I post a new video, she will always like make a little story update being like, hey guys, go check out Lady Survival's video. And we've been friends for a few years now. I'm pretty sure she found me through my YouTube channel. channel a while ago, but she's been so good with like supporting me, and anytime that I would go live on Twitch with Derek, she would always be there. And we kind of have like a little friend group of just a couple people that all kind of mutually know each other. And I really wanted to give her a shout out. This is her Instagram here. We'll see if it wants to focus. So her name is Michaela Love, and her Instagram handle is A Girl Unwritten. I know that that's probably backwards though, but yep, here's her page. We both really love like Killstar. My camera's gonna be dark for a second. We both really love Killstar and just like goth aesthetic, and she's really, really cool. But the main thing that I wanted to bring up is that she is actually an author, and she has a book called The Maiden of Flowers, and she's coming out with an audiobook for it at the end of the month. When the audiobook comes out, I'm definitely gonna get that because I find it a lot easier to listen to books, especially because I like walk to work a lot, so it's easy to kind of do while I'm walking, or even while I'm playing WoW, I can just kind of listen. Because I mean, even with the WoW Chronicles, which I mean, like, I'm ultimately obsessed with World of Warcraft, and it took me a year and a half of owning these to finally start reading them because I'm just so busy always playing WoW and talking to my fiancé, visiting with my fiancé, or working, and blah blah blah. So I'm definitely really, really excited for the audiobook. But anyways, you can get the book on Amazon or Barnes & Noble. So I just kind of wanted to show you guys the little Amazon page and the cover of the book. There it is there. So it's called Maiden of Flowers, and it's kind of like a fantasy vibe kind of book. So yeah, that's pretty much all I wanted to bring up about that. I think it's so, so cool that she's actually like written and published a book, and it's actually available on Amazon and Barnes & Noble. Like, that is crazy. I haven't done anything that cool, that's for sure. Anyways, I will link all of that stuff down below to her Instagram and YouTube and Amazon store and all that, where to get it. And if any of you watching my video actually also follow Michaela Love, because I know that there's a couple in my little friend group, make sure you hype her up in the comments down below. And yeah, other than that, I don't really have a whole lot to talk about. I'm going back to work today. It's been 5.5 months since I've worked, and today is going to be my first day back, and I'm kind of nervous, kind of excited. I'm happy to see everyone again, and I just feel so lucky that my work is letting me come back after me basically having to quit for 5 months in order to go and see my fiancé. I've just been really good over the years for any time that I've gone to see my fiancé for like a week or so, and any time that I've had to quarantine. I just feel really lucky that they've treated me so well, and that I've been there for like 8 years, almost 9 years. It's like literally insane. I'm not sure how long it's going to be until I get to move to the States, but I'm pretty sure my visa is close to being done. It's probably going to be another 2 months, and then I might get my interview, and then once it's approved, I get to move. So I'm not going to be in Canada for much longer, so I'm really, really grateful that I get to go back to work for a little bit and see everyone again one more time, and to be able to make some more money before I move will be really helpful as well. But yeah, that's pretty much all I want to talk about, so I will see you guys in the next video. Bye guys!